Hello everyone, today we'll be discussing using your library card at home. My name is Taylor Bauger and I'm a reference assistant at your different public library. Today we'll be discussing using the Libby app to read ebooks and listen to e-audiobooks on your iOS or Android phone or tablet, as well as your Kindle Fire. Please note, if you have a Kindle Oasis or a Kindle Paperwhite, you'll have to access our online catalog using chester.overdrive.com. So to start, what we want to do is we want to download the Libby app. To do this, if you have an Apple device, you'll use the Apple App Store, or if you have the Kindle Fire or an Android device, you'll go to the Google Play Store. So from here, I'm going to go to my App Store, and I'm going to select the search function, and I'm going to search for Libby, which is L-I-B-B-Y, and when I execute the search, it'll bring it up here. We want the little Libby by Overdrive option. So what you can do is, normally it'll say get or download, but because I already have it downloaded onto my device, it says open. So I'm going to select open, and it's going to bring me into Libby. Now when I do that, it asks me, do you have a library card? So you select yes, and it will guess your library, but I actually think it's more accurate to just type it in. So I'm going to hit search for library. I'm going to search for Paley Library, because that's my home library. And you'll just select whichever home library is one for you. And I will select Paley Library, and it'll bring me into Libby. Well, it'll ask me for your library card information. So I'm going to input my library card information, and once I input the library card number, it will load, and now if I hit next, it'll bring me into the Chester County Library system. So this here is the interface you're going to use to download books. So now that we're in, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to use the app. There are three different functions down here at the bottom. You have library, shelf on the right-hand side, and then in the middle you have the little Libby girl. So that's your currently reading section. To start, I'm going to show you how to use the library section. So this is where you find materials. One thing that I really suggest is setting preferences. So if you hit the little preferences button here, it will give you all these options. So if you prefer an e-audiobook over an ebook, you can select audiobook, or you can just select books so that you can access just those. For me, I'll leave it any, just because I like both books and audiobooks. And then you also can change the language. So for me, I only read English or listen to English. I don't speak any other languages. So I've selected that one. And then you hit apply preferences, and it will change the preferences of the materials that will show up in your library. Another thing that you can do is you can browse through some curated collections. So here we have librarian likes, and we have library reads, just added, some of the most recently added materials, and you can explore different subjects, so Craftapalooza, which is a fun one. So those are really fun, different curated collections made by the librarians. So now, if you find a resource that you're interested in, what you can do is you can say, I want to read If I Never Met You. I could select that, and wow, look, it says place hold, which means that it's not currently available. So you'd place a hold, and then once it's ready, it'll email you. But if I want something that is available, what I can do is I can go to Available Books and say I want to read Outlander. I could hit Borrow. So that's the difference between Borrow and Placehold, and you would select whichever one works for you. Now another thing that you can do is you can set a tag in the library function. When you set a tag, you just hit Tag, and you can do the little books option. You can do the thumbs up, meaning you liked it, or the thumbs down. You can also add a custom tag if there's something that you personally would like to tag your resources as, and then you can create the tag. So once you've done that, say I want to save this as a book, what I can do is I can see that in my shelf. I can go back to shelf and tags. Now that we're in shelf, what I can show you is I can show you your loans and your holds. So these are your tags, and that's how you access them. But you also have your loans. So these are the things that are currently checked out to you. So here I have the filter bubble in a book format. And then I have the All This Could Be Yours in an audiobook format. Now, if I go back to my shelf, I can also access my holds. So these are the things that I placed holds on. So I have the In Cold Blood audiobook, and then Thinking Fast and Slow book that are my holds. If I'm not ready for something, I can hit Manage Hold, and I can either cancel it or deliver it later. So delivering it later is like suspending a hold, so you don't get it immediately. So I'd hit deliver later, and I can select a certain amount of days, and I would hit update hold, which is a really great function. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to use the currently reading section. for your ebooks that you've already downloaded. So if I go back to my shelf and I go to the filter bubble, which is what I'm currently reading, I can select that. And here it gives you the option to change it to your Kindle device, if you have a Kindle device, or you can read it directly in the Libby app. So I'd select that one, and it'll bring me up to where I was currently reading. Now you can review how far you are in the text by going to, by hitting the middle of the screen and bringing up this menu. So you have here, I'm 47 of 513. If I click that, it'll say, oh, you have 40 pages left in the chapter. You can also see what percentage done you are in throughout the book. So that's looking through how far you are within the text. You can also search within the text. So say I want to search in this book, I hit the search function up here at the top, and I can search for, say I want to search for relevance, since I was already on that page. I can see every instance the word relevance is used within the book. So I can go back to erase for relevance, which is where I currently was. I can also create a bookmark, and I can review it later. So if I want to set a bookmark here, I can do that. And to review it later, I hit the three lines, and I select bookmarks, and there's my bookmark. Another thing that you can do is access the table of contents through this menu. So this the three lines on the right-hand side, when you do that, it'll bring up your menu, and you can see the table of contents. So I can see that here I'm on page 47. And there's quite a few pages left in this book. Another thing that I can do is I can set my reading settings. This is something that I particularly like. I think the font's very big on my screen. I actually like to make it smaller, so I can change it right here. I can go to text scale and I can make it smaller. If you're somebody who would prefer larger font, what you can do is you can scrub it to the right, and then if it's even too small, then there's also accessibility sizes. So you can extend the size there. So I like mine very small, and I like it in dark reading mode, so like white on black versus, you know, white, black on white, depending on whatever you're interested in. If you do sepia, it'll look like that, and bright is the normal black on white, but I like dark. And you can also do the publisher's default, or you can change the font. So personally, I like the font Georgia, so I always set it to Georgia. Another thing that you can do, if you are dyslexic, there's an open dyslexic font that makes it easier for you to read. Going back, now that's everything for looking through an ebook. If you have an e-audiobook, what you can do, so here I have All This Could Be Yours, the e-audiobook by Jamie Attenberg. I can select that. So you see here, you have the play button, so you can start it by hitting play. And then if you want to pause it, that'll be pause. And then what you can do is you can, again, see how far you are within the text. So I still have 7 hours left. I have 1 second elapsed. And I can see how much is left in the chapter. And again, I can see what percentage I'm at. So another thing that you can do is you can speed up the reading. This is something that I personally really like because I like to put it at 2 speed. So if you click on it, it'll increase by 0.25 and I could take it all the way to 2. Once you get there, if you hit it again, it'll take it back to 1. Or if something is not quite, you know, perfect at 1.5 and 1.75, you can click and drag down and you can change it to 1.65, and then it'll be the perfect speed for you. Another thing that you can do with the e-audiobooks is you can set a sleep timer. So you can click on that and it'll do 30 minutes. Or you can click and drag. It will give you the end of the chapter is an option, or you can set however long you think would be right for you. So there I've set a 40-minute sleep timer. Again, you can set the bookmarks in the same way you would with the ebooks. You'd select it there, and now you can see your bookmark right here on your menu. So if we go back again, the menu is the three lines on the top right. If you select that, you can also see your table of contents here. So again, you can see all of the different time periods that the next chapter will be. So that is the Libby app that's using ebooks and e-audiobooks through your iPhone or tablet. If you have any questions for us, please let us know. We're happy to answer any of your questions through our email address, which is tpl@ccls.org, or what you can do is you can chat with us online through our website, tradiffrentlibraries.org, 10 to 5, Monday through Friday. Connect with us on social media or our Discord server. And make sure to hit the subscribe button here on our YouTube page. We have some fun story times, as well as some great virtual technology programs like this one. And we're also doing some book talks to find your next best read. Thank you for listening and have a good day.